Pat, do you want to flush the catheters?
Make sure you keep yourself balancing.
Yep. Oh, perfect.
Yeah, you can see it. It's about a meter and a half.
Right?
Yeah.
Beyond.
I work closely with every single medical student here. They come in 4 to 6 at a time, a lot of simulation, a lot of time in the OR, and then watching them just love to learn is probably what I love the most about it. Having them take that away as lifelong learners and being inquisitive and curious.
When we're thrown into a clinical situation, another part of the brain starts to work because it's new to us and we have to relate it to that previously acquired knowledge. And so we are actually exercising different parts of our brain when we're taking care of a patient in this deliberate practice setting, and then later on clinically. So I think our students would tell you that they love coming here. They almost always get something big out of it. And I don't mean just one experience, but to get a chance to think about the way they're going to be as physicians. So there's a lot of meta-cognition that goes down here. We really, in the debriefing, try not to think about a particular case. We try to generalize it to how we're going to take care of cases in the future. And how did we think a certain way that was not helpful to the patient? How do we avoid that in the future?
Sir, how are you doing? Sir? Is he breathing?
He's breathing, but not on the right.
It's a lot different taking a standardized test than it is to have a patient present to you with asynchronous data, urgent circumstances, the pressure of everything around you, and then to try to make a disciplined process of a decision. And we like our students getting that early on. After a simulation, we are in literally a different state of mind. And properly guided, a group can really sort out with genuine honesty what has happened and work towards really being better the next time. And it's an astounding thing to watch. People let their defenses down in favor of really becoming better doctors. It's humbling to see. And it's very hard to get to that emotional state without the simulation. I mean, that's what gets us there. But then the real harvest of that is to be able to talk very sincerely, and people change the way they think and practice. And this has been demonstrated in the literature. It is incredibly effective in terms of getting people to change behavior. I think this is a foot in the door of helping students understand the best way to learn.